The Detroit Police Department is being accused of going too far, surveilling Gaza war protesters.
Now the city's top cop is reacting to that allegation.
CBS News Detroit's Jack Springate is on your block at DPD headquarters after speaking with Chief James White. Jack, what was his response to these claims?
Well, Chief White told me he wouldn't necessarily categorize this as surveillance, rather using publicly information that was posted on social media to anticipate potential violations of the law. Now, a new Detroit Free Press article claims that they went further than just using social media to monitor the activity of Gaza war protesters.
As a general rule, we're not running around surveilling anyone, particularly not protesters.
Chief White says there's a difference between surveillance and monitoring harmless social media posts.
But I think where the confusion comes in is this notion of surveillance from the standpoint of us watching you because you want to protest. That is absolutely factually incorrect. But if someone were to go into a social media platform, that you're going to caravan and block traffic, or you're going to commit civil infractions or criminal infractions, absolutely that is something that would interest us.
Two of the Detroit Board of Police commissioners say monitoring social media accounts in this manner is firmly against their policy.
To my knowledge, none of that is occurring in Detroit. Police are only allowed legally to get involved with citizens when they have probable cause. So in the absence of that, they have no right, at least in my opinion, to surveil anyone.
DPD officers should not be surveillance social media posts. It's definitely a violation in the Detroit Police Department and board's policy.
The policy itself reads, the freedom to speak, dissent, write, and publish, and to associate privately and publicly for any lawful purpose without governmental interference or impairment is a constitutional guarantee that is to be scrupulously honored by all members of this department. It is intended that surveillance shall be undertaken only in connection with the police department's law enforcement activities. The Detroit Free Press obtained documents from the department they claim contain names, photos, addresses, vehicle information, and social media activity of dozens of people involved in a May protest against the war in Gaza. However, the document doesn't specify if they've committed any infractions, according to the article. Bernard says any infraction that might have landed them in that document could have been as minor as jaywalking.
As an attorney, some of the tickets that were issued in Detroit were for things like walking in the street. Give me a break. I mean, you know, this is totally inappropriate.
And many of those claims stem from that May protest when an officer told a protester to, quote, go back to Mexico, end quote. The department cleared up the context behind those comments, saying they came from the officer recognizing that protester based on social media posts she made while on vacation in Mexico. The department says that officer will be held accountable if they're found in violation of the policy by investigating and monitoring someone who is not accused of violating the law. Reporting live outside DPD headquarters, I'm Jack Springate, CBS News Detroit.
Jack, thank you for that live report.